is Christmas Eve, and we're hitting back and fucking by. I do have some terrible news. So, the bad news is that the other day when I recorded the chest day, you know, the first day back, I had about 12 minutes of video that got corrupted. Well, not the video, the audio got corrupt. And I went off on like some, on a motivational tangent, and I was just looking out, and it was just coming from the fucking heart. And it pissed me off that that's the only part that got corrupted. Everything else, all the stupid ass bullshit I could have said, didn't get fucking corrupt. But the only thing that got corrupt was the motivational fucking preach. And they don't want to see me fucking win. Like, you can hear what I'm saying, but in the back, there's just this static that's loud as fucking annoying. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through the audio and, I'm going to go through the audio and write down everything I said. And then I'm going to read it back out on the podcast. And if you don't follow the podcast, it's called the Dead Broke Podcast. It's also on YouTube and on Spotify. So I'm going to say it on next podcast that we film. I'm going to say what I said, as well as a bunch of other shit that we talk about. So yeah, unfortunately, that happened, but it's okay. I took my pre, and I'm ready to get a fucking back and by pump, right? Back and by. You know, we're going to start off with back and end off with bicep because, you know, the bicep is already too fucking big. Well, not really, but I just don't get the same feeling, you know? I got to worry about building other things while on this cut. But yeah, so we're going to mostly focus on back and then, you know, do two or three bicep workouts, but obviously super intense. Yeah, it just pissed me off that shit was corrupt. It's Christmas Eve. To be honest, I don't know if it'll be packed or empty. Hopefully it's empty, but you know, these people think they're fucking David Goggins, you know? Nah, I'm the only fucking David Goggins. So yeah, gonna go get this fucking pump. I'm supposed to be cooking a turkey for dinner, but guess what? What's more important than a fucking turkey? Back and bicep pump. So yeah, I edited about three videos. Video is currently out now for the fast. I actually got to promote that, my dumbass. But yeah, I like just recording the workouts and at the end talking and just putting it like in between the clips of what I'm about to do. So I think I'm gonna continue with that format. So yeah, I'll talk to you guys on the first fucking workout.
All right, so first off, we're gonna start with lat pull downs. We're gonna have these wrist straps on it so that we isolate the lat when we pull down and don't use any other muscle. We're gonna do about four sets till failure. Now we're going to do reverse lat, where you put your back against the same machine and you're just going to pull it forward, and then also after that pull it backwards, so it's just alternating lat spread. We're also going to do four sets till failure. Right now we're going to do machine cable pulls. These are going to be heavier sets, lower reps, just build strength. Yeah.
Oh.
right now we're going to do machine back rows, where we have our chest pressed against the cushion of the machine so that we don't have any other moving muscles and we can isolate the back row. And here we're going to do force and still figure as well. We're going to do cable high to low back pulls, where you start with the high cable and a V-bar and you bring it down to your hips, and you are in a sort of RDL kind of back stance, where when you pull it down you puff your chest out and make sure you bring the V-bar all the way down to your hips. We're gonna do four sets to failure with that as well. Now for bicep, we're gonna do dumbbell curls with a supinated grip. We're gonna do alternating, so one at a time. We're gonna do heavier and just focus on the full contraction. You're gonna wanna bring it all the way to the top and make sure you flex your bicep. For the last set, we're going to do the Mike Mentzer barbell curl, where it's a normal barbell curl, but when you bring it down and up, you go way slower and you just focus on contracting the muscle. And it's also more of a neutral grip when you bring it up and down. You want to have your lats tightened stabilize your arms so that it doesn't wiggle and move, and make sure your elbows are still in the same that your elbows are parallel to each other and they're not like crossed in or anything. You just make sure you isolate the bicep, and you want to bring it very high as well and squeeze and focus on the contraction. We're gonna do that about 4 sets of 12. So that's the end of the workout. I don't know why, but the pre-workout didn't kick in at all, and I had a full scoop. And I just felt like dry, like my lips are dry, and like my whole body just feels dry. I don't feel like I had like a flow state or anything like that while working out, which is pretty sure because it's fucking Christmas Eve. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to do the sauna and then the steam room. And then hopefully later today I'm going to try to do some cardio. I think I'm going to go for another hike or just around my neighborhood just to get some in, because it's Christmas Eve. And I feel like I don't think I'm going to eat a lot, to be honest. Cooking a turkey, so it's a high protein. And I'm still going to stick to my diet, so we'll see how that goes, but I'll talk to you guys in the car.
Alright, we are all done for the workout. Hella time in the steam room, sweating profusely. So, I'm surprised there was a good amount of people on Christmas Eve. I mean, tomorrow I do have some bad news. So, tomorrow I get out of work at 2 o'clock. Yes, I work on Christmas. I am a broke boy who is trying to get millions and millions of dollars, alright? So, I'm doing what I have to do to make it. Point is, the gym is open from 7 to 1 tomorrow. I work from 6 to 2. Do you see the problem? The gym is gonna be fucking closed! So, I am going to look at their other location, which is the premium location, whatever their signature fucking location. Check out later on my phone to see if the signature location is going to be open. And if it's going to be open, then guess what? We're going to the location that's farther away. Whatever, suck it up. And then from there, go to the fucking Everglades, because it's right next to that. So, I could kill two birds with one stone, because I still need to get a pump tomorrow. Tomorrow's leg day. Leg day on Christmas, Santa, that I'll be the one taking the motherfucking sleds, brother, with these big ass fucking quads. So, unfortunately, I'm gonna have to figure out how to have a massive fucking Christmas Day leg day. So, also, for New York, when I go, I do have some bad news. I have limited space in my bag, and I'm not going to be able to take all this camera equipment, I don't think. So, there's going to be a week of me not filming. I am going to try to record ahead. I am 3 days ahead so far. So, 2 or 3 days, I don't know. So, there is that. But I will also be behind again. But whatever. I'm going to figure out how to make it work. I can't record on my phone, dude, because my phone is so shitty quality, and I have literally like 1 gigabyte of space. So I have like 10 seconds of recording before my storage is full. So I can't do that. And I won't be able to edit the videos, because then I can't take that laptop. So we'll figure that shit out. But successful day. My back felt pretty pumped. But I did see some people that went to my high school, and they were pretty fucking, one lost a lot of weight, and one gained a lot of weight, but good weight, because that motherfucker used to be skinny, and now he's jacked. The other person used to be a flubba-dubba, and now they're kind of shredded. So it really made me think, what the fuck am I doing? I really gotta get my shit together, man. And, you know, I said the last videos, focus, do what I'm fucking doing, ignore everyone else, and focus on my fucking workout, because that's all I really can do, and do my fucking best at that shit, you know? And fuck, man, it is pretty fucking hard. It is hard. Like, working out's the hardest, it's always the diet. I feel like no matter how little I eat, I still gain weight. We are still at 228, which is phenomenal. Which means all that water weight I lost and shit potentially was not all water. because I would have gained it back within a couple of days. Not all of it back, you know, at least 5 or something, few pounds, but I've been consistent with this fucking diet. And I did, I think I'm pretty sure I said, I don't know if I said I want to reach 220 by the end of the year. Yeah, I said I want to reach 220 by the end of the year. Lose 20 pounds. I'm down 12. I have 8 more pounds to lose. What fucking day is it? It's the 24th. I have 7 days. I have 1 week. Fuck! Fuck! In 1 week, there's going to be Christmas. Well, today, Christmas Eve, I'm Hispanic, so we celebrate fucking today. Tomorrow, I'm really going to be consistent with my diet because I'm really not going to fucking do anything tomorrow, like, feasting-wise. I'm eating turkey, so I'm going to have a lean fucking, you know, a lean meat. So I'm going to just have leftover turkey. I'm not going to have no extra fucking sides. I'm going to just have hella protein. So I'm going to have hella turkey for a couple of days. Huh. Damn, damn, damn. And then there's the 20... Today, what fucking... Today's the 24th. Tomorrow's the 25th. 26th, I also work, so I'm going to be good with my diet that day. 27th is my day off, but I'm going to be active the whole fucking day. Preview, the podcast is going to be recorded at the beach, and we're going to have an end of the year fucking special for the podcast. So, we're fucking balling with that right there. Then, what the fuck else? That's the 27th. And then the 28th is I leave. I still work the 28th and I fly out at night, so I should be fine. I get there. And then the 29th, 30th, 31st, I'm gonna be in New York. And I might have a slice of fucking pizza because New York. And I don't know how my diet's gonna be, and I don't know if they have a gym. But I know I'm gonna be walking all fucking day. Alright, alright. Fuck it, I'm not gonna be able to weigh myself. Alright, let's say I control myself in New York because I'm also going to be doing a lot of walking. Let's say they have a gym. Even if they don't have a gym, I'm going to wake up, do 100 push-ups, do 100 bodyweight squats, do 100... What's the other thing? There's push-ups, bodyweight squats. There's one I'm fucking missing out. Squats, push-ups. Whoa, 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 whoa. Whatever the other one is, I'm going to do the fucking other one. Everything, I'm going to do fucking bodyweight workouts in the fucking morning. Whatever. Not eat anything sugary, you know, obviously count my fucking calories, everything, boom, boom, boom. I'm gonna do fasting since I'm on a fucking vacation, so I can eat within an eight hour period, eat more, you know, more lenient foods, but I'm gonna be fasting, so it'll be good. All right, that's what I'm gonna try to fucking do. Okay, and I'm still gonna get my body weight workouts no matter what, you know. Push-ups till fucking failure. Bodyweight squats till fucking failure. Okay, okay, I'm gonna be walking a lot. Oh my god. So, we can... I don't think I'll get to 220 by the end of the year, because there are 7 days. I think I could potentially get to 225, you know? I'm gonna weigh myself before I leave on my trip, and if I get to 225 before my trip, which is 3 pounds, in 3 days, no, 4 days, 3 pounds in 3 to 4 days, then I'll call that a dub, because 15 pounds is better than 0 pounds, okay? So that would be a successful fucking, goal. And that was in a month. I mean, let's be real, the fast helped me out losing 15 fucking pounds, because losing 20 pounds in a month is, you know, not fucking reasonable. But I still fucking did 15, which is 75% better than what I wouldn't have been doing. You know what I mean? So that is pretty good. I got a lot of fucking writing to do. I got a lot of fucking, you know, thinking and pondering to do. Because next year, man, I really want to take off, you know. If we're being reasonable, let's say I want at least 1,000 subscribers on YouTube. That's pretty fucking reasonable. That'll allow me monetization. Reasonable goal, 1,000 subscribers on YouTube. Dream goal, you know, super potential. Let's say I go viral, something pops off, everyone fucking, you know, supports me and loves my content. 10,000, 50,000, you know, that's super reaching out there. But guess what? Shoot for the moon, and even if you miss, you'll be amongst the fucking stars, brother. So, I want at least 1,000. Instagram, I want 10,000. I want to be, I don't know, I want to be making money from this, even if it's like $2. Because then, you know, it'll give me hope for, you know, the potential of being... of being someone and somewhere with my fucking life. Whew. All right, we can fucking do this. We can fucking do this. And next year, you know, the fucking goal is be absolutely fucking diced. Maybe get into competition. I don't know. Maybe compete. But first things first, by my birthday, I gotta be 180 pounds. So I am currently 228. Which means I need to lose 48 fucking pounds, all right? And maybe at 180, I'll be bone dry, fucking 1% body fat. I don't care. Look, whatever weight me being fucking shredded with abs is, and fucking veiny everywhere, and fucking striations on my fucking body, you know? Whatever weight that is, that's the weight I want to fucking be. Whatever, sorry. I need that physique. So that's the goal by my birthday. All right? And I already know when I come back from that fucking trip and I'm like, because I'm going to turn 21 on my birthday in 2 months. Right? And I don't know about you, but when I turn 21, that's like a big number, brother. That number is like, oh shit, you're a fucking grown up. You got to do your fucking shit. You gotta get your shit together and make this shit fucking work. And best believe I'm gonna make that shit fucking work. So I need to have some sort of credibility. I'm gonna buy that big ass fucking calendar from what's his fucking name? David Goggins' friend, isn't this like Jesse something? Whatever. I'm gonna buy that big ass calendar. I'm gonna have the whole year fucking planned out. I'm going to put a 5K, a 10K, fuck it, marathon, fucking triathlon. I don't care what it is, because I know when that date's on the fucking calendar, I'm going to have to fucking show up and put in the fucking work, all right? All that motivational shit I said that got fucking corrupted, it's going to fucking come back one day, and I'm going to start fucking preaching on y'all. Start fucking preaching on y'all. Maybe it's tomorrow, because it's going to be fucking Christmas, and I'm going to look back after the work, and I'm like, damn, what the fuck? It's Christmas, and I'm working out. Oh, all right, but that's the end of the motherfucking video. All right, like, comment, subscribe, share, you know, help a brother out. One thing can make me go from here to here, and that's also applicable to your fucking life. You know, you can help change someone's life, go from here to here by doing one thing. You never have to watch my videos ever again, but if you like, comment, subscribe, or share, do one of those things, never have to watch my videos again, you helped someone out today. And it doesn't have to be me. You can go compliment someone on the street, tell them they have nice shoes, tell them they have a nice shirt, tell them fucking anything, because you don't know what they're fucking going through, and you can help save their fucking life. You don't know. So you might have fucking saved someone, you might have made their day better, but at least you did something fucking good. Try to do something fucking good every fucking day, all right? Try to be fucking better. So, that's the end of the fucking video. I'll see you guys tomorrow for fucking Christmas, and we're gonna hit these fucking legs, all right? Even though the video is gonna be 3 days ahead, on Christmas, tomorrow you're gonna see a fucking chest workout, which is pretty good. But that's not gonna be on Christmas. So, let's get fucking shredded, and I'll see you guys fucking tomorrow.